So what do you do when you have a photo like this? You charge extra. But what if they don't pay extra? You simply upload this to ChatGPT and say, fix this photo. But will it work? You see, I've tried dozens and dozens of platforms that claim to repair old damaged photos with AI, but when you try them, there are two problems. Number one, either they just sharpen or bring back the details on the face and forget about the rest of the body and the background, or they recreate the entire image and it's not even the same person anymore. So how can we at least make sure that it's the same? Oh my gosh, that is pretty darn impressive, I have to say. Here is the before, this is the image that was all scratched up, and here's the after. I am impressed. Let us try a better prompt, and this time to get it more cleaner, we are going to request to restore this old photo to look as if it was taken today with high-resolution digital cameras without changing anything about the image. Just repair it, clean it, and sharpen it. But even if you do that, I highly expect there's going to be something very uncanny about this, and it's not going to look like the exact same person, but can we improve upon it? Let us take a look. Now here is the result we get. Very, very impressive, but still doesn't look exactly like the same person. So how do we make it better? Let's open this up in Photoshop and see if we can make magic. We just have to match the face. Clothes and stuff, they move a little and it's absolutely fine. So let's bring in the original image. I'm going to go to my Finder. Here's the original one. Just drag it and drop it right here just for a reference. I'm going to make it smaller. And as you can see, it is almost similar, but the lips are not kind of matching. First of all, let's go to image, image size. Let's upscale it a bit and we can add details later. Let's go for 2000 by 3000. Hit OK. Keep it automatic. And as you can see the lips here and see the lips there. They are slightly different. Also, the face shape needs to be adjusted. Very easy to do in Photoshop. Just with the background layer selected, press Ctrl or Command J, and this time we really need to be artists. Go to Filter, Convert for Smart Filters out of good practice so we can change the values later, and then go to Filter, Liquify. Now, when we are in Liquify, we can make changes here, but we also want the reference in the corner. So for it, just scroll down, choose Show Backdrop. Remember the name of the layer in which we had the reference? It was Example 1 Restore. And we want it to be in front, not behind, in front. Let us decrease the opacity slightly, because if you increase it and try to make any change, this error is going to show up. So let's decrease it at about 74. It shouldn't be an issue. And now you can, of course, use the forward warp tool at the top and push things in like so. But you know what's easier as a first step? Scroll up and you will see Face Aware Liquify. Just open it up if you're not seeing it and it will detect the face, and from here adjust whatever you want. For example, the lower lip needs to be a bit larger. So let's scroll down into the lips section, mouth section, lower lip. I'm just going to extend it a bit more. There you go. Mouth width, let's make it slightly larger. Now it is getting closer to the original one. Let's go to the face shape section. Make the jawline narrower, like it is in the main one. And if you want to be super accurate, you can also superimpose the image. But to my eyes, this just feels like a more natural way to do it. Hit OK once you're satisfied. And there you go. This is so darn much closer. Now, while we are at it, why not do a couple more adjustments with brightness and contrast? For it, let us create our favorite adjustment layer. Click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. Make the brights brighter. We already have a lot of space here. Take the rightmost slider to the left, like so, to this point, and do the same with the left hand side. There you go. So much more pop, so much more drama. I think I like this. Let us have a look at the before and after. Here is the before and here is the after. But I don't think it's always going to be that simple. But if you have a photo like this, the face is much smaller, has lesser details. It's not an easy face. Also, there are so many details in the photo, and I'm damn sure this is not going to be easy. But how do we make it better? Let's get it to ChatGPT, type in the same prompt, and apply it. By the way, if you're really interested, you can get the prompt here or just copy it from the description. Now, this one is a color photo, which is a good thing. The details on the body are intact, but here's the biggest issue. It's not the exact same person. It is just somebody else. The first thing we can do is try a couple times, maybe two or three times, until we get something that looks similar. So I'm going to go ahead and try a few more times and see what it does. By the way, if you just want to generate colorized photos, you can easily type that in the prompt, as in colorize the photo as well, and it should do that. Now, this photo is closest to the original in terms of structure, but the face is absolutely not matching, and it's going to be very tricky to match it. But I've got a trick up my sleeve. So here we have it opened in Photoshop, and on top of it, we are going to open the original one. Just place it there, hit enter or return. And to align the face best, let us change the blend mode from normal to difference. Anywhere there's a misalignment, it's going to show up with this blend mode. Control or Command T, and move it so that the eyes align like so. Now, it's not going to completely align, but we'll try our best. Hold the Alt key or the Option key and click here to place the anchor point there. If you're not able to see the anchor point, make sure this is checked. And then we are going to make it larger or smaller to make sure that everything is matching to its best. So let's make it slightly larger. Things are matching pretty well. And we are going to leave it at that. Hit enter or return. Now let's change the blend mode from difference to normal. Now, can we actually recover the face from this original image, keeping everything intact? Let us try it. Photoshop actually has a way. Let's go to filter, neural filters here. And Photoshop has a photo restoration thing. It does the face good, but not the rest of the body. So let's try it here. It is better, not the best. Let's enhance the face even more. So that's one of the things you can do and then match the face. Another way is if you have Topaz Photo AI, you can try that too. So with this layer selected, press Ctrl or Command J just to make a copy. And in this copy, you are going to take away the neural filters like so. And we are going to apply filter, Topaz Labs, Topaz Photo AI. By the way, if you do want to check it out, here is the link, or I'll also leave a link in the description. Now, Topaz does incredible face recovery. Add enhancement, recover faces. Now, you've got two options. By the way, did a pretty amazing job. There is the realistic option. There is the creative option. See what works best for you. Increase the strength all the way to 100. Realistic or creative? I'm going to go with creative. Export to Adobe Photoshop. So here is Photoshop's result. It's good, it's not bad, but Topaz is on just another level. So we are going to use it. You can use Photoshop if you don't have Topaz, absolutely fine. Now to fix the teeth and to close it, let's create a brand new layer. Select the remove tool here and just paint over it. As simple as that. You want to make sure sample all layers is checked and just paint over. Now we just want this recovered face over the ChatGPT face. So let's select this layer. Hold the Ctrl or Command, select this layer as well. Both of them are now selected, Ctrl or Command G. Hold the Alt key or the Option key, click on the mask button to create a negative mask. Now let's take the brush, soft round brush with white as the foreground color. You can always press X to toggle between the foreground and the background colors. Just bring back the facial features. Now it is starting to match real good. But what about the colors? You can actually steal the colors from the ChatGPT photo itself. With the background layer selected, press Ctrl or Command J. Place it at the very top and change the blend mode from normal to color. And you can limit it just to this area by holding the Alt key or the Option key and click on the line between these two layers. And you can actually name this color. Now I know this looks odd because we need to correct the colors. Not everything was lined up. So let's create a brand new layer. Hold the Alt key or the Option key and click on the line between these two layers as well to limit that. Change the blend mode of this new layer to color. Now take the brush, hold the Alt key or the Option key, click to take a sample and just paint to fix colors. For example, this area seems weird. Hold the Alt key or the Option key, click to take a sample and paint to fix it. Let's do the lips. Hold the Alt key or the Option key, click to take a sample and just paint. Once you feel the colors are okay, now it's time for us to adjust the contrast. So just below the color layers, we are going to create another curves adjustment layer. Click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. Because if we had created above them, it would slightly disturb the colors. So now let's take the left slider to the right to add more contrast. Similarly from here as well, just to make sure that all of it starts to match. And there you go. But there is something about it that is not letting it match. First of all, whenever you download an image from ChatGPT, it is over sharpened. Look at the edges. These artificial sharpening, we need to first take that away. So just with the background layer selected, press Ctrl or Command J to make a copy and let's name it slightly blurred. Let's go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Let's blur it just 1 pixel. That's it. All of this just goes away, or even 0.8. That's more than enough. Hit OK. And now it's matching a little bit more. Don't worry, we can sharpen all of this later. And at the top, select the topmost layer first. Press Ctrl, Alt, Shift, and E to create a stamp visible layer. In other words, a layer where everything you see on the canvas is now merged. Let's go to filter, convert for smart filters. Go to filter again, camera, raw, filter. And just so that we can bring everything together, first let's go down, go to the detail section. Let's increase the sharpening all throughout and then just add a slight bit of grain just so that everything comes together. Maybe 20 and increase the size a bit. Maybe a little less green. 12. Hit OK. You can skip all of this, do upscaling, that is up to you. But here's the overall before And here is the after. This is a crazy night and day difference. So AI by itself is right now not enough. You need a bit of HI or human intelligence to bring everything together. I hope you enjoyed a video like this. It was spontaneous. I didn't plan it ahead. I was just experimenting and I thought maybe I should share it with you. And if you enjoyed videos like this, let me know in the comments and make sure to give us a like. And also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe. Ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tips, tricks or tutorials. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating. What can I do?